are so many things I could say right now. I'm so cynical.
Am I? Marriage was never intended to last more than a few years.
And where did you get that?
Anthropology 101. The concept was invented by cavemen with a life expectancy of 25 years. Till death do us part meant 4 or 5 years tops.
That was very enlightening, Dinozzo. And I do understand now. You think like a Neanderthal.
You are so...
coordinated?
Adolescent.
I prefer the term fun-loving. Oh! Oh, hey! Food fight. Remember your first report, Kate?
Yes, Gibbs made me rewrite it twice. Felt like I was in grammar school again.
He only made you redo it twice?
I forgot to spell check. Huh. How many times, Tony?
Can I catch a peanut in my mouth without missing?
Ha! Did you have to redo your first report for Gibbs?
A few.
What'd you feel?
5. Would have been more, but I took pity on him.
Oh.
McGee. Good job. Send it up to the director.
Will do, boss.
Any more food fights in here, I'm joining in with peas.
Frozen peas?
Nope. In the can.
I'm Anthony Dinozzo, Mrs. Mallard. I work with your son. He called, said I'd be coming over.
You're Italian.
Yes, I am.
You're a gigolo.
Well, I wouldn't exactly call him.
You move furniture.
I could.
I have a commode that has no business being here. It belongs in the lounge. I've told Donald this. He never listens.
I understand. Okay, if you'll just show me where you want the...
Who are you?
Anthony Dinozzo. Everyone calls me Tony.
That's an Italian name.
Yes, it is. So if you just show me where you're...
You're a gigolo. If you look down my blouse, I shall disembowel you.
That's funny.
I have a knife in my brassiere.
I'll keep that in mind.
Good. And where are you going with my commode?
I'm your son's co-worker. Remember, Tony Dinozzo? Italian gigolo furniture mover?
Tony, and for your information, men and women can just be friends. Right, McGee?
Technically.
What do you mean, technically?
He means she'd have to be pretty ugly first.
Wait, I didn't say that.
Besides, it's a pretty brave thing to do.
What do you mean, brave?
Well, crawling around back here, all this poison ivy, I don't know if I would have done it.
You're kidding, right? Leaves of three, let them be.
McGee?
The creepy way Gibbs used to sneak up on us?
What do you mean, used to?
The old man's been wearing Bengay lately. I can smell him coming a mile away.
That a fact, no, so.
Knee feeling better, boss?
Yes. Much.
Great. Okay, that night.
Do you think he did it, Gibbs?
Oh, yeah. And Tony is cleaning it up. Janitorial.
Yes, sir.
Don't worry about interrogation. Dinozzo's gonna handle it. You still here?
Are you serious?
You're serious? Oh. In my defense, I did use the word creepy in the most affectionate way. Right.
You might want to use gloves.
Where's McGee?
What I don't understand is how did I get it all over my face?
It's the urushiol oil in the plant. Yes, once it gets on your hands, it spreads by contact.
Then I have a major problem, Ducky. When I was out there, I had to, you know...
No, I don't.
Relieve myself.
Oh. Oh. Well, let's take a look, then.
This is kind of embarrassing.
Dr. McGee, I have seen everything there is to see more times than I care to remember. Good Lord.
What? Well, is it bad?
No, it's fine, fine. nothing to worry about. I didn't expect to see quite so much swelling.
If Tony finds out about this, I'm gonna have to quit.
Well, your secret is safe with me.
Doctor, I've got the new inspection forms you request. I'll come back.
Him, I'm not so sure about.
Okay, what do you got for me?
It looks worse than it is.
I'm not so sure about that.
She means you look like the Elephant Man, Proby.
Tony.
It's true.
Can you still work, McGee?
Yeah, sure, boss.
Will you please tell him that men and women can just be friends?
Absolutely they can.
Without having sex?
Oh, no, they'll have sex. Abby. What, Kate, you never slept with a friend?
What is wrong with you people?
Good question, Kate.
I'm a year, gaining weight, I got knots.
That's because you sleep in a chair.
It's not a chair.
It's a knot chair?
It's a top-of-the-line, comfortastic brand, gentleman's reclining chaise with a pretty terrific massage feature and pretty fantastic cup holder.
It is a massage chair that gives you knots. It is not healthy.
I can assure you, dear boy, with the passing years, the knots do not get any looser. For the sake of your health, give up the chair.
Can we just not say not anymore? Thank you.
So what are we looking at here, Dougie?
So I would give you odds that he did not. It would have been quick.
Hey, will you stop tapping your fingers?
I'm not just tapping my fingers. I'm watching his taillights. It's Morse code. F-U. E-L.
Fuel. Tony, they're stopping for fuel.
Yeah, you're done with the coffee.
What made you pick these horses?
A keen mind, an eye for natural talent, a little bit of luck, and of course, they spoke to me.
Who spoke to you?
The horses, the ponies. I whisper to them, they whisper to me. Actually, no, you can study them before the race. The ones that really want to win, they do this little dance, a little snorting.
Tony, you may want to stop acting like a jackass.
That's not an ass, it's a whore. I can explain, sir.
Settle in, doctor. This should be good.
Look, I've got a cousin that works for a concert promoter. Every now and then, he helps me get tickets. It's not a big deal.
Then why didn't I know about it?
You know why.
If I knew why I didn't know, then I would know what I didn't know. You're a bad man.
You know what? I didn't tell you because I knew that you would take advantage of it.
You saying I'm a bad man?
Should I come back later?
No way. Did he tell you it was the school mascot? No. What was the MIT mascot?
It really doesn't matter.
Oh, yes, it does. Stewie.
A beaver. He was Tim the Beaver our senior year.
Please tell me you dressed up like a beaver.
Of course he did. Little teeth, just remember the... Oh.
Evidence points to you. You bulletproof, Jin.
Did she just sigh at Gibbs?
Yes, she did.
You might want to play back my confusion later.
Special Agent Gibbs, your accusations sound a little crazy.
And we can't find him. But we're not going to give up until we do.
Or die trying.
Or die trying? You had to put that in his head?